Dolphins, superstar wide receiver. He rises when it matters most, and he comes in third in the NFL in touchdown receptions. It's the Dolphins and the Bears, and it's all
up next. Now, the skies certainly
aren't
cooperating, Bronk, but for a lot of those guys on the fields, this is perfect football weather. As we welcome you to another presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. Up in the booth alongside Brock Huard, I'm Kate Scott, and we are grateful to be up here today because, well, it's been raining pretty heavily all day, and that's certainly going to make it challenging to operate if you're either one of these offenses, Brock.
Yeah, I think that's a fair point, Kate. Now, hopefully you practiced this week knowing some rain was in the forecast. Hopefully everybody on the sidelines, the umpire on the field, and all the footballs they will use today shuttling in and out, you can have that grip. And I'll also say this, keep an eye on the gloves. That technology...
Well, this weather is not cooperating as we're set to go. And here we go from Miami. This one's fielded at the 4-yard line. And he's brought down just inside the 25 on the return. So out come the Bears, ready for their first possession. And they're brought out by a player with immense expectations and promise in the league. He was picked first overall in 2024 out of USC, Caleb Williams.
Nobody came away happy last week, no question about it. Himself, most of all. His team went 0-1, picking up the loss. But he was 0-1. One pick, no touchdown. Not good enough. Defeat not an option this week, and neither is a lack of touchdowns. They intend to rectify both. This is one of those plays that I wish we had the huddle mic'd up, Kate, because I can assure you that offensive line, in their own way, is telling that running back, sorry, we did not give you any chance.
He found some running room for a nice gain. Held it about 70 yards on that run. Now it's going to be third down and 4. Williams will look to throw. Complete beyond the marker. And he's tackled with the first down yardage.
That's what we call situational football. You spend all week working on your nickel passing game package to take advantage of third downs just like that.
Here's a give up the middle. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
This is one of those situations, Kate, where I watch the body language of the running back, because it'd be very easy for him to raise his hands up, look to the sideline in his O-line and go, what am I supposed to do there? There was nothing, no time at all to try and escape and react. Instead, it goes backwards.
Going run again with Swift. And he's taken down after a short rush at about the 36. It's only a gain of 1. Back-to-back misfires on the ground, and they're facing third and long. To throw, Williams. And the Dolphins are there to bring him down. And the defense comes through to back him up ahead of fourth down.
All right, first sack on the board on the first drive as a defense. And now, well, now we let the chess match begin. The adjustments begin because we know pressure leads to sacks. And sacks in this league often leads to wins.
Fourth down, it's Torrey Taylor on for the Bears to punt this away. And this will bring a drive that had some promise to a disappointing end. And he'll have this fair catch right along the 25. So here come the Dolphins as they get set for their debut series. And they'll be led out by someone that we'll get a look at here, this second-year passer.
He's one of the select group of quarterbacks where when he takes the field, everyone, and I mean everyone, takes notice. He's part of the game's elite at the game's most important position, and it really is a spectacle, Kate, anytime he leads an offense out, because you know he's capable of plays that other quarterbacks in this league simply cannot make.
And they needed more than one defender there. Powerful runner stopped for just 1 yard. They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9.
Brings up 2nd and 9.
Now looking to throw. Tight end reels in the shallow throw. And this one's brought to a halt at about the 36-yard line. A new set of downs forthcoming. It's 1st and 10.
1st and 10 at the 36-yard line.
He'll look to throw. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he's short of the first after a mild gain. Second and six coming up here. He's gonna throw this one. And oh, someone stepped in. It's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And the Bears are gonna have it after his second interception of the season. Not the auspicious debut they'd certainly hoped for on that opening drive. The coverage, impressive, taking their first possession away with that interception.
Hey, it is tough to play a clean game in this league. Caliber defenders are awesome. You just hope that eventual missteps happen at a less meaningful moment than your opening series. You don't want to make it any harder to get your rhythm and get your passing game going.
Let's see how they attack this first down, Brock, from the 43. Here's Williams. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he takes it just inside the 40, down to the 39. Halfway to the marker, it's second and five. From the 39. Into traffic, complete. And he'll be brought down at about the 29. They come through with a nice gain there. Gain of 10, first down. Get it to Moore. And he'll get it down to the 24-yard line. Well, we see the medical staff headed out there now. We're going to get a timeout as they handle an injured player. Not what you want to see so close to the end of the season. Halfway to the marker. It's second and five. From the 24. That throw finds Komet. And that tackle stops him after a solid game.
Sometimes when you're just looking to move it forward, get some small yards on the throw, quarterback's best friend, security blanket. And when it's a big old tight end, that's an extra bonus.
Has his man, it's Swift. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's good for a Bears first down.
You're not going to last long in the National Football League if you don't convert a good chunk of your third downs. Nice find there to continue the series.
Down. He's charged towards the line. It's right around 3 yards.
You know, they got some positive yards. That's a good thing. But too many plays like that, it just is too hard to pile together, get first downs against the better defenses in this league.
And he's tackled after gaining a handful. And now we'll get a pause here. Trainers headed out to take a look at an injured player. Let's hope it isn't anything that's going to keep him from finishing this season strong. Third and just two to go. Now Williams. He's on the move. Trying to get away from the pressure, but he can't, and they drop it. And the defense comes through. That's going to back him up and bring up fourth down. On to try the field goal, Harrison Butker. Very short kick here from the right half. All right, still scoreless through one quarter, but that looks like it's gonna change pretty soon. Hopefully no shortage of excitement coming up in the second. Back to Hard Rock Stadium right after this. Out now are the special teamers to try a Bears field goal. It's only a chip shot from the right hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that's going to break our tie and give them a three-point advantage.
Well, I know once that drive stalls out, that's where it really pays to have that reliable kicker on the sideline ready to bail you out. And he knocks that one right through to give them the lead.
And that's where they'll begin the drive following the return. They're out and set, first and 10. Now a give on the counter. And he found some running room for a nice game. Call at 9 yards. Looked like a first for a moment. It's second and one.
A gain of 9 brings up second and one.
They go play action here. He's going to push one deep down the right. That one is incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact. Tough one to retain through that hit. So it's going to be third and short coming up. Now it's a bootleg for him. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not until he reaches that 45-yard line. A 19-yard pickup, and that's going to move the chains.
Part of the reason I leave you pregame, Kate, and get down to that field and watch these guys throw and catch is I want to see their timing. I want to see their anticipation. That is picture perfect right there. A crossing route thrown that quickly tells me these two are on the same page.
Back to pass on first and 10. He's going to get this complete to his running back. And he's tackled for a short gain. 8 yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down.
At the 44-yard line.
Throwing off the play fake here. That won't be caught outright. It's incomplete. Couldn't make that connection. And that's going to leave him with a tough third and long.
8 yards to go.
Throwing now off play action. Ooh, on him quick there. And they bring him to the turf. And the defense comes through to back him up ahead of fourth down.
You just feel this defense starting to come alive, don't you, Kate? Got their first turnover last time out. Now they put their first sack on the board. In big plays on that side of the ball, well, they can come in bunches. Defense sure hopes to keep this faucet going, and the offense wants to turn the spigot off immediately.
Here's someone from a family of punters, Ryan Stonehouse, on to punt on fourth. He was only needed twice in last week's win, and he gets this one away. The Bears about set for their next possession. And they settled for a chip shot field goal last time, Brock. You got to think they want to be able to finish it off and reach the end zone here. Drive starts out with a first and 10. Williams set to pass. And his perfect start is over. And that's the first one of his throws to wind up incomplete. So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Out of the gun, they'll give it to him inside. And he's just spinning his wheels, man, this entire first half. They drop it behind the line.
I know from the position of the quarterback, Kate, sometimes you hand that ball, you put it in the belly of the running back, and you send him right into the teeth of a buzzsaw. You can feel it from the jump, and that call from the defense, well, it came at the perfect time.
Deep down the middle. And the Dolphins are going to have it after his second interception of the season. Well, I know I don't need to tell you, Parker, but if you're going to try to get aggressive, really push a throw downfield like that, you have to be smart about how you do it.
Yeah, that is spot on, Kate. If you've got to find that spot when you know the coverage won't be able to hold up, especially as you go 20, 30, 40 yards down the field. Hey, listen, these defenders in the league today, you throw a ball deep down the field like that, it turns into a 50-50 ball. More times than not, they can make a play and take it away just as they did.
They've got first down from the 31.
All right, now let's get in that end zone.
They'll throw to begin this drive. Splits a couple of defenders and completes it. And he's got a decent gain before being brought down. Second and six coming up here.
At the Bears,
from the 27. It is cut left side. And he'll be brought down here at the 23-yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's third and two. Quickly looking left, and it's complete. And that short gain is enough for a new set of downs.
You know, they call that the money down for a reason, because you're just simply not going to last long in the NFL if you don't convert a good portion of your third downs. It's the money down. And nice to see them roll the dice and continue the series.
Gets to space right side. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. That one goes for 15, and now they're going to have first and goal.
You know, the elite running backs in this league, they don't just see what's right in front of them. You set up big runs like this because they see what's behind them. That's called extraordinary vision and extra yards.
Pushing for the end zone, and it lost the football. It's not loose.
Well, that looked like a last-gasp effort to deny them a touchdown. He came with one final wild swing at the ball, and he connects. They get off the field with the touchback, but they're...
And he will score! Touchdown, Miami! The Dolphins parlay the turnover into a lead. Tyreek Hill, the touchdown. All right, partner, what do you think? Was that a design read, or did he just see space and he was reacting more on the old quarterback instinct there?
Yes. I think yes on both of them, and that play happens so fast that it really is instincts on both sides.
Now Jake Elliott on to attempt the extra point. That one splits the uprights, and they'll continue adding to their lead. The Dolphins have their kickoff team out as they kick it away. This one's fielded at the 4-yard line. And this drive will start inside the 25. Here come the Bears back out on offense. They are coming off their first interception of the game. This drive now a chance to rebuild some confidence. Running behind center with Swift. And he gets a few on the plunge forward. We've hit the 2-minute warning now at Hard Rock. And it's the Bears with a 2nd and 7. Now here's Williams. Throw reeled in by Allen. And he's going to be brought down up at the 28-yard line. Third down from the gun. Look, he's taken down. The Dolphins rush gets home. Now the Dolphins call a timeout. It's their first. As they'll get together and discuss with fourth down coming up. Torrey Taylor on the punt. And this will be his 2nd effort of the contest. Got 46 on his first punt, so this one's pushing a little more distance. And a sure-handed play there in the rain. He brings in the fair catch without a problem. The Dolphins are being led back out there on offense by their quarterback. And no one has been better than him at finding the end zone through the air all year. He's leading this league in passing touchdowns late in our season. Airing it out to start this drive. Quick hitter complete. And he's short of the first after a mild gain. After a good pickup, they've got 2nd and 4. From the 38. Pass complete to his back. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
Just get this guy touches. I don't care how. I don't care when, just find unique ways to get this running back the ball, and over time, he's going to make it pay.
And this one does not go far.
Kid, I don't know why every once in a while I get these little flashbacks, but a little play like that just flashes me back to the preseason, my first preseason. And one of the veteran QBs said, hey, Brock, whatever you do, just find completions. You will never go broke taking a profit. Go get a completion. We're at a premium in this league.
They are throwing it again. Here's a throw on the out route, complete. And he's out of bounds, just short of the 30. Nice spot here for the offense. It's 2nd and 1. From the 31. Fires over the middle, caught. And they bring him down. Looks like he got it to the 27. He brings the offense up now for a 1st and 10. Takes the handoff, now to throw. Throw caught at the 6. And that play is brought to a halt, so they're going to say at the 5-yard line. They were chuck a field, and it sets him up with first and goal. Working inside the red zone. Has it in close. And he will score. Touchdown, Miami. The Dolphins will add to their lead at the end of the half. So, Brock, this offense looking sharp here in the first half as they extend their lead.
You know, and when things are going well, sometimes you really just get into a groove. And this is a unit that's putting the pieces together.
Attempt the point after. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. The Dolphins have their kickoff team out as they kick it away. And he opts not to bring this one out, so they're going to enjoy some good starting field position from the 30. Keeping it simple, they're just going to call a give right up the middle. And he'll push this upfield and earn them a new set of downs. Looking to throw. And the Dolphins are there to bring him down. Timeout Chicago, it uses its second. A single second left now on the clock.
This is why we hear about closing speed so often when you evaluate players. You know, once he senses the pressure, he's getting rid of that ball. It takes a player who can close quickly to get to him before it's released and alter that throw.
So we've reached halftime down here in Miami. The Dolphins have a lead. Now it's up north to Orlando for a look around the league. We've got Jonathan Coachman and the EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Kate, we'll get back to you and Brock in a bit. For now, plenty of early action in the 1 o'clock Eastern window to get you caught up on. So let's get to it. We'll start up at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. And those two are tied up as they play the second quarter. From there, we head down south to Atlanta. Check on the Falcons at home at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. And for the moment, they trail the visiting Saints in that one. Chuba Hubbard. Two touchdown runs on the afternoon. Lastly, let's head up to the Twin Cities to check in on the Vikings at home in Minneapolis. And that game's gone to the half, all tied at 3 apiece.
As always, a hat tip to Coach for his hard work during the break, as we're happy to welcome y'all back for the start of our third quarter. It's going to be taken in at the 8. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30. And he has continued to own this defense and keep on throwing that football, partner, making this performance one that he's going to remember. But as you like to say, the defense would probably rather forget. Motion man sent left. They go play action on first. And he'll be brought down after getting it to the 47-yard line. This one goes for an even 25 yards. And that's going to get the Dolphins a first down.
I love throwing that first down. And when you see a first down pass just like that, it's taking advantage of a matchup you plan for, and you go out and execute.
One play in, and this drive is already into enemy territory. Throwing from the gun. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. They gain 14 on the play. And it'll be first down, Miami.
They've run this 12-yard hot route, Kate, at the combine. Well, all the way back to last century when I had to throw it. And this throw, this is a big boy throw. It's a differentiator. Can you make that deep out throw on time, on rhythm, and accurately? Well, that was teaching tape right there.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Thrown back, it's the handoff. And he's going to take this only to about the 31. Only 2 yards on the play, and it brings up 3rd and 8.
A 2-yard pickup makes it 3rd and 8.
Look into the air here. That's caught for the first. And he's brought down. They're going to mark him at the 14. It's a gain of 17 on that one. And that's going to give the Dolphins a first down.
Well, that is a well-designed route right there. He really made it easy to get that pass to him. Creating space, QB receiver, deliver.
And the play clock hits 0. This is going to be delay of game. Must have lost sight of the play clock there, Brock, because the quarterback could have snapped it in time, but instead, they take the penalty.
Still first down.
So they should be a little prompter in snapping this, you'd hope, Brock, after that delay of game. Back to throw. Looking right, and he brings it in. And he's going to be stopped at the 17-yard line. Everyone's prepped. It's 2nd down now.
Brings up 2nd and 13 at the 17-yard line.
Throwing from the gun here. He's going to get this complete to his running back. And he'll get this inside the 10 to the 9. Here they come. This is 3rd and 5. Shotgun snap. They're going to throw. The Bears close it in, and they'll get him. And the defense comes through. That's going to back him up and bring up 4th down.
I know we talk about rhythm a lot when it comes to music, but it's the same thing with a quarterback and his protection. This QB was in rhythm, but they knocked the notes out of him on that one.
Jake Elliott's on now to attempt this field goal. It's a 34-yarder from that right hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that extends their lead to 14.
Well, that's the type of long, sustained drive that takes some of the starch out of your opponent. The only negative is if the kicking team is out there for a field goal and not an extra point. But they do come away with 3.
That's going to be taken in at the 8. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30. Chicago getting set to take the field now. And this game might be going better if he could have some more time just to work back there. This pass rush has been all over them, really keeps taking this offense out of any grooves that they've managed to get into.
Okay, I like to say in life, there's energy givers and there's energy vampires.
Yeah.
And for this defense, these sacks right here, they're such energy givers. And man, it's like a vampire sucking the juice out of an offense.
Yeah, I love that. And they're going to bring him down just beyond the 30 at the 31. 2nd down now, 7 to go. Staying grounded with Swift. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. Just 1 yard on the play, though. That leaves him a 3rd down and 6 to go. Williams will look to throw. He had it for a moment, but a great defensive play to jar it loose. Incomplete. Well-timed strike by that defender to knock it free. And now a 4th down staring right at him. Chicago brings out the punting unit. And he sends this away. Definitely his best kick of the game thus far. Fair catch hauled in at the 18-yard line. We don't get a return out of that punt. And the Dolphins will have some work to do as they take over. We'll start out with a 1st and 10. Now come out throwing. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he'll be brought down along the 25-yard line.
That is a textbook 1st down completion. Sets up 2nd and very manageable and creates space to take that shot downfield.
from the 25 on second down. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he'll get it up to the 44. That play goes for 19 and a new set of downs.
You want to start a good debate sometime, Kate? Go in an NFL locker room and ask which position is the best athlete. The big guys, the left tackles, will tell you it's them. The corners will tell you it's them. But I'll tell you what, these tight ends of today, the way they can run and break tackles and get in the open field, they truly are some of the best athletes on the team.
From the 44-yard line now, first and 10. Shotgun snap, looking to throw. Rifles it, and it's caught. And he has this one past the 50 and will start downhill into Bears territory. Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one.
At the Bears 48-yard line.
From the 48. Tight end reels in the shallow throw. That goes as a gain of 25 yards and picks up the first.
Yeah, I love that effort. Adding as much as possible to that catch, not earning the first down. That's called yards after catch. And it's what coaches want from all their pass catchers on the roster.
No hesitation, and that one's caught. And he'll go down here at the 16. Second and three now.
Brings up second and three at the 16-yard line.
We're through three on this holiday weekend. This one not out of reach quite yet, but it is a two-score game to begin the fourth. Second and three now. From the 16, he brings it in, and they bring him down at the 7-yard line. 9-yard pickup, and it sets him up with first and goal.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
They'll throw it again. Catch made, and he will score. Touchdown, Miami. The Dolphins make it a three-possession game. Well, this machine has been firing on all cylinders this game, partner. And it continues firing as that lead grows yet again.
And those who've tried to get in the way of that machine you're talking about, namely the defense, well, they've paid the price over and over and over again.
Elliott on now to attempt the point after. That one splits the uprights. And they'll continue adding to their lead. The Dolphins have their kickoff team out as they kick it away. This return starts at the 5. And in the end, he's able to get it to what used to be a touchback. It's at the 25 after the return. And Brock, we got a pretty good idea how a lot of the playoff picture is going to shake out, but still some time left for things to change near the end of the season. Offense ready to begin this drive, first and 10. Now Williams. Scott reels it in. And he's brought down after a nice gain and a first down.
I know the combine tries to test everything it possibly can physically, but I don't know how you test courage at the combine, because there's nobody defending you. Nobody wants to hit you. That was the epitome of courage to make that in cut and make the catch.
And he'll be brought down a step or two shy of midfield. They're going to mark him at the 48. After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. Now here's Williams. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free. Incomplete. He was looking Keenan Allen's way there. And now it's third and short. To throw is Williams. Pass caught by Adunze. And he's brought down after pushing to that 35-yard line. The big play nets him 17 yards. And that's a Chicago first down. Here's Williams. That's complete. Here's Scott. The end result there, 15 yards and a first.
A gain of 15. First down there.
Out of the shotgun, they'll give it to him inside. And he's into the front for a gain of about 2. Now after that play, we have somebody banged up down there. Injuries never welcome sight so close to the end of the season. They're out to attend to him. 8 yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. Off the play fake, he's gonna throw. Headed out right. Oh, he was on the move, but so was the defense, and they take him down. And that pushes him back. Third down coming up. Williams set to pass. Here's a throw on the out route, complete. And he has it down officially to the red zone at the 20.
Feet and eyes, Kate. Feet and eyes, they so often tell the story of every position on the field. When that quarterback's feet and eyes move to his secondary read, and so often it's a tight end, well, it's incumbent on that defense.
And he'll score, touchdown Chicago! The Bears take a small chunk off that lead.
Well, they definitely wanted to get that one out quick, Brock. They did just that, and it ends in 6.
We hear it all the time, but it is so true, Kate. This is a game about matchups. And when you see a throw that quick, it really was determined pre-snap. It was great design and tremendous execution.
That one right down the middle. And they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. They recognize the situation they're in now. After that score, they're going to try to get it right back. And the Dolphins get on that football. And he'll have it down to the 44-yard line. Well, kind of feels like we're starting to get to that point, Brock.
And what point is that, Kate?
You know, the bold point of the game where you have to try something bold could end up becoming a play that finally sinks him though.
Yeah, and it's time for desperation. Without a defensive stop here, it's really hard to lay out the scenarios for much success. Every second matters now when you don't come up with that onside kick.
From the 44-yard line now, first and 10. Airing it out to start this drive. A lot of speed on it, too tough to handle, incomplete. Looking for the back that time. And it's going to be second down. Now they'll throw out of the gun. Ooh, fired a dart there, but it's not going to be brought in.
Hey, Kate, I know it's unrealistic to expect a 100% completion rate from anywhere on the field. But in this close, you really shouldn't be missing too many throws. Those need to be borderline automatic.
Third and long for him here. Splits a couple of defenders and completes it. And this one's worked down to the 33 before being stopped. It's a pickup of 11. And it'll be first down, Miami.
I may love watching a great thrower, but I love watching a well-done route too, Kate. Make that guy think you're trying to stack him only to drop your hips and cut right inside. Some good work to help reset those chains.
On first down, they'll run. And they try to power it forward, but only a couple of yards there.
That's a pretty good stop on first down. This defense now gets a chance to dictate, and that's what all the great defenses want to do, Kate. They want to dictate it on their terms and not just be reacting to what the offense is always doing.
And he'll manage to get this one down to the 27. Give him 4 on that run. That's going to bring up 3rd and 5. It's the 2-minute warning from Miami. Dolphins moments away from celebrating their 14th win this season. So now here's 3rd and 5. Now he'll throw off the play fake. And he won't escape the Bears. Take him down. The Bears decide to call their first timeout. And they still have two available for them as we approach the end of this game. Jake Elliott's on now to attempt this field goal. From the right hash, this is going to be a 51-yarder. And this kick is good. He needed to get all of it there, and he did. And that makes this a three-score game.
We got ourselves a three-score game now after that make. It's got to feel like it's going to just about do it, with any hopes of a comeback still smoldering. I think these kickers enjoy those opportunities, Kate, to be the one to kick this lead out of range.
And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. The offense headed back to the field. And this a final opportunity to make things a little closer in that final score. To throw, Williams. Search it. He's taken down. The Dolphins rush gets home. Puck working against him here as they hurry to that line. That's going to be an incomplete pass on the throw to the right. Not on the same page that time. So they're left facing third and long. Williams to throw. And even on third down, he sees no choice other than to get rid of it. Not the play they wanted. It's going to be fourth down.
So often, so many of these games in the NFL, well, they come down to a play or two, and third down's critical. Whether it's in a close game or already out of hand, the coach wants to see them convert those.
So the defense rises to the challenge and gives the ball back to their offense.
Even the best receivers, they've got occasional breaks in concentration. You just never want to see it happen. One of the most important snaps of the game. If we know anything about this guy, though, it's he'll be up for the challenge the next time the ball comes his way.
Here's the lone back on the handoff. And he'll get this inside the 10 to the 9. That's a gain of 13, and it sets him up with first and goal.
Kate, don't think for a second this is time you step off the gas. You can feel this defense, right? They're on their heels. And now's the best chance to go push the envelope and get aggressive.
Right back to him on first and goal. And he's charged towards the line. It's right around 3 yards.
Hey, I get it on first and goal, right? A lot of teams like to be conservative and limit risk. Even if a run is stopped short, you still got two, sometimes three downs to play with.
So it's fins up as the Dolphins take the win at home. And they continue playing their best ball of the season over this recent stretch as they pick up a sixth consecutive victory. And with Brock Heward and our EA Sports crew, I'm Kate Scott saying so long from this one.